Good evening, everyone, and welcome to St. Monica's 2017 end of the year concert. This year we are doing something a little bit different. I wasn't allowed to have the microphone, so obviously people have been talking about me hogging the speakers and all that sort of stuff. So all I will say is thank you for another amazing year. We honestly couldn't do it without the people sitting in the chairs, the people who are out the back in their classrooms. We couldn't do it without you. So thank you very much. Have a wonderful Christmas. Have as much of a relax as you can. Me, who's going home to no children, no anything, we'll pray for you round about the 24th of January. So thank you once again for coming. Enjoy tonight's performance. Just some safety features. We need to keep this centre aisle free and the back aisle free because our performers will be coming down that way. You are welcome to take photographs as long as you don't stand in front of our videographer and as long as you don't block the side emergency exits. So welcome and enjoy.
Oh, Stella! very good. Can we do it again for you? I was the one keeping us together.
I got the routine completely right for one. Why do I think I was the best for it?
I'll get you!
We've been working on our radio superstar smiles.
And of course, everyone wants to be a superstar.
Mr. Mars, who was the superstar to do in the play?
Shine. Shine like a true superstar. Like the birth of Harold the King of Kings. Think about it. An amazing star showed up in the night sky. The star led the three wise men to Bethlehem. The star shone over the stable where Jesus was born. And the shepherds found the stable lit by starlight. And that's why the nativity musical this year is called Superstar.
I thought it was called Superstar because Jesus is the superstar of the Christmas story.
Oh, Stella!
No, she's hit on something really important. Stella, you might not always get things right on stage, but you have certainly got the Christmas message exactly right. Would you like to try out the part?
Me?
You can do it!
Go on, Stella!
We'll help you!
You'll be brilliant!
You'll be brilliant!
Don't
be shy! Do you really think I can do it?
Yes!
Ago, a stray phenomenon appeared at the night sky. A new bright star was seen moving steadily through the darkness. People pointed and wondered what the superstar meant. Wise men and astronomers knew that it was a sign that a new king had been born. Three wise men set off from the east with their princesses. They wanted to be the first to know before this new and important baby. They took with them gifts that were fit for royalty.
That's my cue! Oops! Thank character Stella. I'd better start shining brightly now to get them to follow me. Wish me luck.
Come here, boy, and hold this.
Stop shaking, man. I'm trying to see where we are.
Sorry, Sion. I'm a bit wobbly after all that walking. Are we nearly there yet?
It can't be far. Look, this must be Jews and the men that get to the hills.
But how do we know the new baby king is in Jerusalem?
Trust me, lad. I'm a doctor of astronomy. We understand.
I wish I could be more helpful, but the navigation device I invented seems to be pointing back the way we came. Give it a shake or and check these facts.
I can do that by looking at the sun, Sire.
The sun's gone down, though. Have you learned nothing from me?
I think it's got a screw loose, Sire. Or be all that bumping about in the saddlebag that did it. Shall I see if my Maraha is still intact?
My what?
My Raha.
Foolish girl, Smurt, and it's my gift for the new baby king.
Now that the night has fallen, the superstar's catching my attention. Look, it's up there over the city walls.
It seems to be hanging the sky now while I've been moving.
Excellent observation, my good fella. I was watching to see if you noticed.
It's stopped over by that palace.
Follow the best star!
Look at the guards at the gate. We must be guarding from the scorpion. Shall I get my gold out yet?
No. Let's be wise and hedge our bets. We must be sure about this.
I think my broken suit on the rope too.
Good thinking, Sad. No smoke without fire.
I'm studying the mighty certificate of wisdom.
I'm not happy about this place. And look, the stars on the move again.
And heading towards Bethlehem?
Bethlehem? But nothing ever happens in Bethlehem, does it?
Look like the gods are almost through the gates.
Enter the palace of King Herod.
Thank you.
Oh dear, I don't seem to be doing too well so far. I'll just have to try harder. I've got to shine over Bethlehem next and throw a light on what's happening over there.
Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David, to be counted in the Roman census. The roads were busy with travelers, all doing the same thing. Joseph was worried because Mary was about to have a baby, and they needed to get to Bethlehem as soon as possible so that they could find somewhere to rest for the night.
Do you manage to walk a little faster, Mary? It will be dark soon.
I'm so tired, Joseph.
Good evening, my friend. Where are you headed to?
Bethlehem, it was where I was born.
Meeting my family. My family's waiting there.
Can't wait to see them.
Come on, Mom.
Oh my, you look tired. I wish we could help you along, but it's getting dark. And the babies are getting restless and hungry. Sorry about this. Oh, my old legs go faster than yours.
Shh, Grandpa, we should always help them.
Don't worry, we'll get there soon with God's help. And it looks as though it's going to be a clear, starry night. I'm sure we'll find our way.
Thank you. lovely story. Now, let's welcome the rabbits.
Thank you.
hillside above Bethlehem, the shepherds were guarding their sheep under the bright starry sky, when suddenly they heard singing from a long way off. Then the sky above them became bright with angels and the singing got louder. They began to feel very scared. Something strange was happening.
Thank you.
brilliant when a story has a happy ending?
The three wise men and their apprentices followed the superstar until it led them into Bethlehem. There it stopped and lit up the little stable below with a radiant light. Suddenly, the tired travelers knew that their quest was over.
This must be the place where we find the King of Kings.
Let us worship this special child.
I have loved being a superstar for this play. But we all know that the real superstar is baby Jesus. Make sure you shine this Christmas to tell everyone that Jesus was born for us.
Merry Christmas, everyone!
they amazing? That would have had to have been the most engaging nativity story I have heard out of a very long line of nativity stories. Well done, everyone. We don't normally do this, but I'm going to do this year because around about this time, or 1 week before every year, every teacher in the school is incredibly stressed because they are putting on the school performance. This year, Annie and I were saying how relaxed it has been for us, but not for Doris and Maria. So Doris and Maria, can you come up, please? This year, how about we? And we all went, And then she said, I'm thinking that I, and we all went, that is a fantastic idea. But it's amazing. We've never done anything like this before. They've worked like navvies. If you're old, you'll know that a navvy is a hard worker. They've worked like navvies since the beginning of third term and beyond. And I think that they've done an amazing job with our kids.
Seeing there's a microphone in front of me, I'll just use it. I'd like to thank all of our kids here at St. Monica's because they have worked so hard and they've been so engaged in what we've been doing and really have enjoyed it, and it's been really fun doing this with everyone. So let's give them another big round of applause. They're really superstars.
I'd just like to say the same. Thank you to our students for the amazing job they did. We had one who went on holiday and took a script with her. So well done, Angelina. And thank you to all the parents for coming tonight and helping them with their costumes. Thank you.
So at this point, our evening is over. We got it finished before the alarm goes, which was always a good thing. So that we are safe, the children are going back to their classrooms and you can collect your children from their classroom. So, one more clap. And seniors, would you like to go? Middles. Abigail, go down. Go down the steps. And juniors. Thank you, everyone. You can leave the chairs there. We'll pack them up in the morning. Thank you.